We'd like to welcome you all once again to Saturday's Story. The Lord is dealing with my heart about some verses of Scripture that I really feel like that we need to talk about. You see, the Church of the Living God was not born in Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John, but the Church was born in the book of Acts, the Acts of the Apostles. And what happened in the book of Acts is what needs to happen in all of our lives today. And this scripture seems to leap from the pages of God's word to me in Acts 1 and 3. It said, to whom he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. He showed himself alive after his passion. He manifested himself to the world and revealed his power by his passion. I'm here to tell all of you today that when the Lord began to search for a word, he searched for a title in the Holy Ghost to describe the death, the burial, the resurrection of all that he had done to consummate our salvation on that cross. He looked for a word that would describe the magnitude and reveal the real power of it all and what was done, and he called it passion. He showed himself alive after his passion. He revealed and manifested himself by the same thing that it's going to take for us to reveal ourselves to a lost world, and that is passion. Passion is more than just an action. Mr. Webster said, let me read it to you, that passion is an intense, emotional, driving urge or feeling that totally possesses an individual to the point of giving oneself to a cause. Passion, my friend, is the birthplace of all dreams. It is the impetus to all action. It is the fulfillment of all desires. It is the inspiration to every spiritual accomplishment. It can all be traced back to your passion. You see, God meets us. He meets us all in our humanity, in our weaknesses. But it's through our passion that he takes us to his divinity and his power. God can only use those who have been set afire with that passion. You see, we're instructed by reason, but we're inspired by passion. The Lord said, you give me a man or woman that has passion, and I'll give you an action that will take place. Because passion invigorates, passion restores, passion ignites our very desires, and passion will defy the status quo. Passion will condemn all unfruitfulness. You see, passion is our permission to do what God has called us all to do. Passion will turn fear-filled saints into fire-filled messengers. Passion will remove you from that place of unconcern to Laodicea limbo, to that place where you are on the fiery line working for God. If you want to search back all the way back to the early church, I'll tell you where their secret was. Their secret was is that they were a people that were filled with a passion that hell couldn't stop, a passion that would not be defied by the forces of the enemy. There was no mountain too tall, no river too deep, no ocean too broad that passion could not cross and that passion could not conquer, because passion, my friend, is the answer that God wants to bring to this people. And I'm here to tell all of you today, if I know anything in the spirit, I'm telling you, God is fixing to bring a revival of passion back to his people. He has promised it. He has said it was going to happen. Matter of fact, Haggai the prophet saw it. He saw where we're living today. I want you to hear in Haggai 2 and verse 6, for thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land. Doesn't that sound like where we are? The shaking that has come to our world today. And he went on in verse 7 to say, and I will shake all nations. And because of this shaking, the desire of all nations shall come. What God was saying is I'm going to shake this earth in the last day. And because of all of this, there will be a revival and a renewal of passion back to the hearts of God's people. This is where we are. This is what we're praying for. Because God's going to shake this world and bring us to that place of passion. A passion to pray. A passion to serve Him. A passion to worship God in. A passion to come out of our hiding. Come out of our quarantine. Out of our fears. Into a realm of faith. It is that passion that God is calling us to today. And this brings me to Saturday's story. It was some years ago. Many of you may not identify with it, but it was the county sale barn. It was a place where they brought animals in. It was a big area of auction, and the animals came out and they were auctioned off, many to go to farms and many to slaughterhouses. And in all of them, there was a stairway that led to a runway that would cause you to look down into the pens, and the pens that contained the various animals. Most of it was cattle, but there were others there also. And so the owner was giving me a tour. Walking down the runway, we came to a large pen, a pen with cattle in it. And he told me, he said, these cattle are going to the slaughterhouse. He said it won't be many hours. There'll be a carcass hanging in a meat locker somewhere, designated to go out to be cut up into various parts of meat to the stores. I begin to look at those animals. He said, matter of fact, here comes the man to mark them now. And everyone that receives the mark, we know that they're the ones that's designated to go to the slaughter. He had a long pole with a marker on it, simply far enough away from the animals not to spook them, but he was marking each one. And there were probably 20, 25 steers in that pen. And he finally came to the last one, the last steer he came to as he was about to reach out. It was as though this steer began to look, and you could see his eyes roll back in his head as though the steer recognized, hey, I don't like this. And all of a sudden the steer began to back up as the man was trying to put the mark of destruction on this steer. Now, I know this sounds strange and this story may be odd to you, but please, I was an eyewitness. I saw this. This steer turned and on two legs began to try to climb out. The owner of the sale barn said, don't worry. Said, this pen is built high enough. It has two big pipes at the top to where that the animals cannot escape. We never had one to get out. I looked at him and I said, well, you may know that. I may know that. But I don't think that steer knows that. Because all of a sudden, hear me, the steer got both legs over the top of the pipe and the steer began to pull. And the owner said, oh my, we never had one get that far either. And suddenly the steer pulled itself until the weight bent the pipe down and over into a hallway it came. He immediately grabbed an intercom, began to call. And suddenly two men at the end of the hallway begin to run with these shocking devices, was going to shock the steer back the other way. But the steer saw daylight. He saw past the shocker. He saw past the two men and he began to run. He began to run wide open. He ran and ran. And suddenly those guys realized this thing is going to run us over. And like a bowling ball hitting pins, knocked those guys. I mean, they one went one way, one the other, hanging on the side of the wall just to escape this crazy steer. Suddenly, the steer didn't even see the gate. He turned that gate into toothpicks. He burst out. And the last time I saw him, there was about eight men, a pickup truck, and two four-wheelers after one steer going out across the field. The next week, I saw the owner. I said, did y'all ever catch that steer? He said, man, the last time we saw that steer, he was headed toward the Mississippi River. And I said within myself, whatever that steer's got, I pray, God, would you give it to some of us? Because you see, you listen to the preacher today. This world is marked for the slaughter. The spirit of the Antichrist, this word said, is already at work. Only he who now resisteth will resist until he be taken out of the way. I feel that God is wanting to ignite a passion in us to resist this mark of the enemy, to absolutely knock you out of gear, to put apathy into your spirit, unconcern into your heart, and to absolutely put you in neutral and knock you out of gear to keep you from affecting the world you live in. I pray today, God, activate that passion to let us defy the forces of evil that has come against God's people and come against the church today. We must have that revival of passion. And I pray right now for all of you that hear Saturday's story, God, ignite them. Many of you have the Holy Ghost, but you don't have the fire. And Jesus said, when I come, I'm going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. You've got the first part, but God, give us that fire. Give us that passion that will move us past our doubts, past our fears, into that place that heaven has called for us. And my friend, the only hope America has and the Church of the Living God has, we got to get back that passion that was once given to the saints, once given to the early church. That is our hope today, a revival of God's passion. I thank you today for tuning into Saturday's story. Please share this with someone, because there's somebody out there that needs to get this passion igniting in your soul again and get up and say, you know what? It's not over. God's not through. The earth is shaking, but it's only revealing what's inside of me, because every shaking will reveal what's truly on the inside of an individual. So God bless you today. Please share this with someone, is our prayer.